Welcome to an animation on the inverse functions of sine, cosine, and tangent. And the goal of the video is to illustrate why the domain is restricted for sine, cosine, and tangent to determine the inverse functions. Remember that a function must be one-to-one in order to have an inverse function, and also that a function and its inverse is a reflection across the line y equals x. So what we're seeing here is a graph of y equals sine x on the interval from negative 2 pi to positive 2 pi. And right away we can see that this is not a one-to-one function because a horizontal line would intersect this graph in more than one point. So if we reflected this function across the line y equals x, we would have an illustration of the inverse of this function. And here we see it in red that this inverse is not a function. It fails the vertical line test. So what we do is, going back to the blue sine function, is restrict the domain without changing the range. So if we only graph the sine function on the interval from negative pi over 2 to pi over 2, what we're seeing is the blue function is becoming 1-to-1 and the red inverse is becoming a function. And there we see it. In blue, we've changed the domain for the sine function from negative pi over 2 to pi over 2. The range is still from negative 1-to-1. And the inverse of sine in red is now a function, so we have the inverse sine function. Now we see the graph of y equals cosine x in blue, and right away it's not a one-to-one function, so if we try to find the inverse of this, we can see in red it's not going to be an inverse function. So by taking the domain of y equals cosine x and restricting it, to the interval from 0 to pi, the blue function is now 1-to-1 and therefore has an inverse function in red. So if we did not restrict the domain on the interval from 0 to pi, the blue function would not be 1-to-1 and the inverse would not be an inverse function. And lastly, we have the graph of y equals tangent x. This function is not 1-to-1, so if we tried to find the inverse of it, you can see in red it would not be a function. So if we take the domain of the blue function and restrict it, to negative pi over 2 to positive pi over 2, and in this case, because of the vertical asymptotes, it's an open interval. And again, you can see now the blue function does pass the horizontal line test, and as a result, the inverse in red passes the function test and therefore is an inverse function. So this is really why we have to restrict the domain on sine, cosine, and tangent in order to find the inverse trig functions. So I hope you found this illustration helpful. Thank you for watching.